Donkey 72 again, and today we are going to do an unboxing. The UPS man came and dropped off a nice package for me, and we're going to take a look and see what it is. And what we have here is a pair of black diamond crampons. So for those of you who watched my last video, this will come in, hopefully come in real handy. I returned my Hillsbound crampons because of the failure in the bindings. After doing some further research, I wasn't really happy with the overall performance of them, so I decided to make a change and try out a pair of these black diamond crampons. But before we get to that, one thing I do want to mention is that the Hillsbound crampons have a 2-year warranty on manufacturing failures. What that generally means is failures like the binding, where the binding sheared off, or the actual rest of the crampon were failures, but they don't protect against misuse. Luckily EMS graciously accepted them back and didn't give me any hassle at all. Really happy with my the customer service over there at EMS. Since I did get the such good customer service, I did go through them again for these crampons, even though they were a little bit more expensive through EMS. They really do have really great customer service and a lot of good helpful employees there who help me out with fittings and discussing the new tech that comes out and the new features that come out and some of the new equipment. So on that note, let's get to the unboxing. So we're gonna there it is. It's like Christmas came again over here. So the one thing that about these crampons that I really did like, you know, some people might say that it's a kind of a dislike for them, is the fact that they are made out of stainless steel. So I get the fact that chromoly rather are better, but or lighter and stronger. But in this application, since it can be quite difficult to have to dry off and depending on the situation and where you're utilizing these crampons. So having the stainless steel eliminates the need for that. Some of the other features that I really enjoyed on these was the built-in snow plates to eliminate the snow from coming up and balling under your shoe. Also the built-in adjuster for the for sizing purposes will allow me to further adjust these crampons to fit my specific need. One also thing to mention is these are complete strap-on crampons. They're not crampons that would normally get attached to a mountaineering boot. So this type of crampon is definitely can adapt to fairly a fairly good sized boot. I believe the recommendation is a 12. Could be wrong. I'll double check on that. But with a vast array of adjustments in the in the slide here, and within the strap here, it gives you the ability to really cinch down on these crampons. The other thing to note on these crampons in comparison to the Hillshound crampon is the aggressive nature of these. The Hillshound didn't really have too much of a front front tooth here, so you know, if you were really going to get into anything with a lot of ice, with some elevation involved, the front Hillshound crampon wouldn't have done the trick, as well as the bottom spikes also have a little bit more of an aggressive nature. I need to go out and do an actual trip test with these. Unfortunately, right now it's about 50 degrees and has been for the past few days. So as soon as it cools down again, it's only mid-January, so I'm sure it will cool down again. Once that happens, I'll probably go out and test them out officially, and I'll make sure to let you all know and see about that and how that works out. So I have, again, this is just an unboxing. I haven't read any of the directions whatsoever, so your guess is as good as mine on how the strapping system works. My guess would be that it would come around something like this through here and then up around across to here would be my initial guess. And then pulling it back through to tighten it up. Now you probably have to do some different layering techniques here to make sure that it's not uncomfortable on the foot. But overall, you know, it's a pretty simple design. All the reviews online that I've read are quite positive about these. So it's, you know, it's overall, I can't wait to get out and use them. You know, the design seems to be simpler, and hopefully have a little bit less failure points. And it looks to be a good construction so far. So until I get out and check these out, I will and update you guys. That'll be it for today. But I just wanted to give you a nice show on these new crampons that will hopefully not fail me in the field. Until next time, Doinky72, have a nice day, and hopefully everybody get out and have a good day and get outside and get outdoors. Thank you.